Amen, amen. Maybe I'm the anti-devil, pro-Christ. Maybe I'm Christ. Have you thought about that?
You ever laid hands on anybody?
How's Christ? Yes. You know what I did? But it didn't work. I went down to Chamaya. You know where Chamaya, New Mexico is?
In New Mexico?
Yeah, so there's a Santorium, where there's sacred dirt, and it's real. It keeps coming back, and people heal themselves. Well, I got down there, and I took some dirt, and I did this, and I guess I don't have enough faith. It didn't work. You know, I tried to heal myself.
Is that a legend?
So I tried to lay hands on myself, and that's the only way I get done is by laying hands on myself. I like that. I like the jets of the hot tub too. If you position yourself just right, even if somebody's in the hot tub with you might go, oh, they don't know what's happening, but you're getting off. I got a thing from Medicare through the manufacturers of the pump, and Medicare will pay for it. There's a copay. I got the literature. They'll pay for you to masturbate. And here's why. If you're in stress, you can relieve heart attacks and stroke. And sex and whacking off relieves stress. So it makes sense. Now I went over to my brother-in-law's house, and my sister just died. And I was telling him, and he says, I got one. You want to see it? I said, well, don't demonstrate it to me. I'll look at it. He says, I paid $110 for it. And the son of a bitch is about this big. It's a big vacuum thing you stick out there, and you pump it up, and you tie it off so the blood don't come. You've got a tie-off deal. And I says, Otis. This Kenny Tribble, we call it Otis. I says, Otis, if you'd join this Medicare, you'd get it for $10 instead of $110. There's a copay. You got to pay the $10. Then you get some good out of Social Security. What the hell's wrong? What in the hell's wrong with those people? Well, that's cheap. Oh, Jose, can't you see that if you do a tour Dewey and use Army, Geithner and Bernanke, we'll print 1.5 million E on your all capitalist corporate trade name E, devaluing the dollar further, and valuating gold and things of intrinsic value, create an economic collapse and one world government. You know where the U.S. Army's largest recruiting office is?
All right.
It should be a U.S. city, shouldn't it? It's Mexico City. That's the truth. Because we ain't got jobs and the Mexicans ain't got jobs. And if they do a tour doing the army, they get,
that's absolutely true.
Like $1.5 million worth.
Really? He couldn't be more true, truthful.
Hey, if you got money out of time, you can get good out of Federal Reserve Note. Like Kohl's has these special sales, and you can go to Kohl's with a Kohl's card and all the deal, and they have everything's on sale, but a lot of people go for sale, but they can only buy one item because they're broke. The money's coming to me. I got a cash flow now because I stuck with it. I can take the Federal Reserve Notes and deem them. Money ain't the root of all evil. It's the love of money that's the root of all evil. And real money is gold and silver. Gold is a hedge on government. Silver is a hedge on inflation. If you can, get silver and get gold. But don't talk about it because somebody will kill you for it. How about that guy that found a can of gold coins and found 8 more? $1 billion, and he started bragging, and the IRS sent him a bill. Once he acknowledged that we're not on the gold standard. So there's no law where you had to pay any taxes on. There's no law you got to pay taxes on any. There is no such law. No judge can show you any law.